Good morning.
Hello.
Good morning. Try that again. Good morning. Can you hear me? Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our all-school assembly. Thank you for those of us who got dressed up. Good morning. Thank you very much for that warm welcome. Appreciate everybody being here for our all-school assembly. It's nice to get together. It's been a little while since we've been together as a school, so it's nice to see everyone here. Today we celebrate Courage for the Deed in the form of Black History Month. I'm going to get right out of the way. First, can we have a round of applause for our performance this morning for our students? Great job. It's appropriate that we have jazz to kick us off. And with that, I'm going to invite all-school president Declan Buckley.
Courage for the deed, grace for the doer. It's words that I'm sure every single Shipley student has heard more times than they can count. For many of you, hearing someone stand up here and try and explain what these words mean is your cue to let your eyes glaze over and wait for the next musical act. Nevertheless, if you'll bear with me, I'd like to go over at least one of these words. Courage. Courage is defined as the willingness and choice to embrace obstacles such as pain, danger, or outright fear. We often shy away from courage because facing these things makes us uncomfortable. However, it is in our discomfort that we can truly create change. Courage can often come in very small moments, like when my brother Evan decided to overcome his crippling fear of ketchup by bravely eating a French fry dipped in some. Of course, courage can also come in moments that have a far more greater impact on our society. Standing up for what you believe in, fighting for what is right, and even just helping out a friend are all examples of courage that we see in our community every day. If we build our lives around these acts of courage, we can truly help make the world a better place. With the theme of this assembly being Black History Month, I'm sure many of you are wondering how a white man who has spent his entire life living on the main line can provide any value to the subject. And you're absolutely right. I can in no way fathom the struggles that millions of Americans go through every day, nor will I pretend to do so. If I stood up here and bragged about how accepting I am and how I am not part of the problem, I would be doing a disservice to everyone in this room. Though I will never be able to truly understand the pain, perseverance, and outright heroism displayed by the people who helped change the world and whose stories we celebrate during Black History Month, it is still my responsibility to learn from and listen to these stories while I continue to strive to be an advocate for equality. Today, we will hear the stories of people who have displayed far more courage than I ever have. For it is not the acceptance of people that is courageous, but the ability and desire to fight for what is right. My name is Declan Buckley, and I am your all-school president. Thank you. I would now like to call up three members of our upper school Black Student Union, Aisha Ali, Sanaya Redman, and Peyton Turner.
My name is Sanaa Redman.
And my name is Peyton Turner. We are three of the many members of the Upper School Black Student Union. We are excited and thankful to join you today for our all-school assembly. As Declan and Mr. Turner both mentioned, the theme of this all-school assembly comes from our school motto, Courage for the Deed. As members of the Black Student Union, we also wanted to take a few minutes to explain both what the Black Student Union do or also called the BSU, and is also the importance of Black History Month.
I hope everyone is enjoying the fifth day of Black History Month, as I know I am. I am honored to have the pleasure of explaining to you all what exactly Shipley's BSU is. I hope everyone is enjoying the fifth day of Black History Month, as I know I am. I am honored to have the pleasure of explaining to you all what exactly Shipley's BSU is and the amazing work that we do. First and foremost, BSU simply stands for Black Student Union and is in an affinity group here in the upper school. The purpose of the BSU is to create a safe space for Black students, as there are many instances where we feel targeted and overlooked in Shipley's predominantly white community. We strive to make Shipley's community better for Black students in the present and for all Black students in the future. Currently portrayed on the screen behind me are the faces of the magnificent members of Shipley's Black Student Union. Both the students and our faculty advisors. I now ask that the members of the Black Student Union rise and be recognized for your hard work and dedication of standing up for the rights and lives of Black students here and around the country. You all may be seated.
As February is celebrated in our country as Black History Month, over the course of the next month, you will hear in your classes about the lives and stories of the life of Dr. Martin Luther King, Jackie Robinson, and Rosa Parks. However, there are so many other stories and histories that make up the fabric of the African-American culture as we celebrate it today. From the fighters like the Tuskegee Airmen to philosophers such as W.E. Du Bois, to contemporary artists like Hendy Willie, the story of African-American history is one true courage takes to overcome racism, prejudice, and insurmountable odds they face in their desire to find equity and freedom for all.
However, though Black history will be celebrated over the month, few know the original of how the month was started. So we thought we would poll the audience and ask you all a few questions to see who knows the real background of how the month began. We have three questions to ask you, and we will see who really knows the true background of the month. Talk it over with the people next to you and see if you can come up with the right answer. All right, are you ready? All right, here's question number one. When was Black History Month originally created? Was it A, 1900, B, 1915, C, 1955, or D, 1975? We're not calling up people. All right. Okay. All right. Sweet. All right. I'll just call on somebody. Okay. All right. If you answered B, 1915, you are correct. Okay. However, it was not until 1926 the first Negro History Week was celebrated, and it wasn't until 1986, close to 60 years later, that Congress and President Ronald Reagan issued the Presidential Proclamation 5443 that officially celebrated Black History Month.
Okay, here's question number two. Who was the original founder of Black History Month? Is it A, Dr. Carter G. Woodson, B, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., C, Booker T. Washington, or D, Rosa Parks? If you answered A, Dr. Carter G. Woodson, you would be correct. Historian and author Dr. Carter G. Woodson created the first Negro History Week and continued this work to push for the betterment of the lives of African Americans over the rest of his career.
Okay, here's our final question. Why was Black History Month originally created? Was it A, to make all Americans aware of the struggle for freedom and equal opportunity, B, to celebrate the many achievements of African Americans in science and the arts, C, to show the importance of African American accomplishments in politics and religion, or D, all the above? If you answer D, all of the above, you would be correct. For these reasons and many more, Black History was created to make all Americans aware of the struggle for freedom and equal opportunity, so that many fought for our country and to appropriately celebrate the lives and stories of so many who have made our country what it is today.
Thank you so much for taking part in our portion of the presentation and for answering the questions we asked you today. We hope that you learned a few things about Black History Month that you may not have known and gain a bit of appreciation for why this month is so important and to so many of us in the country.
Over the course of the rest of this month, you will see many different pieces of Black History Month celebrated throughout campus. This was just a snippet of what you will see over the next few weeks. From pictures on the digital televisions, to questions on tables, to artwork, and even different menu choices and events during lunch. The Black Student Union, in partnership with Shipley, will be working to provide many opportunities for you to learn more about the history of African American culture toward the end of the month. The BSU will also lead an assembly for the upper school dedicated to Black History Month, and meetings in the lower and middle schools. We are excited to share these opportunities, and we hope that they are impactful for you. Thank you.
As we hope we have shown you today and will throughout the rest of the month, Black History Month is both about honoring the past and also creating opportunities for the future. By remembering the sacrifices made by so many in our culture, we can celebrate the courage it took for them to stand up for justice. We can hope we can all share one day. Though only highlighted as 28 days on the calendar, in this year 29, Black History Month stretches throughout the whole year and the impact it has on our community, our country, and our world. We would like to end our portion of the assembly with a quote from First Lady Michelle Obama, who once said, "You may not always have a comfortable life, and you will not always be able to solve all of the world's problems at once, but you don't ever underestimate the importance you can have, because history has shown us that courage can be contagious and hope can take on a life of its own. We hope we will see you this year's Black History Month as an example of courage that will be spread amongst the school and give life to the ideals of justice, freedom, and equality for all. Thank you."
Hi everybody, my name is Chris Cook. I'm part of the wonderful honors combo. Trumpeter and composer Lee Morgan, born in Philadelphia in 1938, became one of the most well-known trumpet players of all time, possessing a sound that is one of the most recognizable and widely emulated amongst all jazz trumpet players. Morgan rose to prominence as a sideman with the jazz great Art Blakey and fellow Philadelphian and saxophone icon John Coltrane. His hit song, The Sidewinder, debuted to surprisingly popularity, crossing over from the jazz world to eventually hit number 25 on Billboard's pop charts. His later years, Morgan became more politically involved in the preservation and advancement of jazz and Black American music in mainstream society, serving as one of the leaders in the Jazz and People's Movement. This group demonstrated during the recording of talk and variety shows in order to protest the lack of jazz artists as featured guests in his short life. Morgan had a prolific performing and recording career. Please enjoy the Honors Combo's rendition of the jazz classic, Sidewinder.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Mr. Jacobs, and I am the Director of Diversity and Inclusion here at Chipley. And I would like to proudly introduce to you members of Ms. Corgan's eighth grade class. We're going to talk a little bit about their experiences, what they're learning in class regarding a couple key members who we will celebrate during Black History Month.
In eighth grade, we began a new unit by examining Langston Hughes' poem, Harlem. In his poem, Hughes asks us, what happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun? Hughes is asking us to think about our own dreams for the future, and that's exactly what we did in English class. Though some of our dreams varied, most of us wanted the same things. A good house, healthy family, good health, and a nice job. All of us know what it is to dream. And Langston Hughes inspires us all to chase after our own American dream.
Interplay, A Raisin in the Sun, Brian Hansberry uses the motif of dreaming. An African-American family who lives in Southside Chicago during the 1950s dreams of a better future. However, the protagonist, Walter, struggles with the fact that no matter how hard he works, he will never be able to achieve his American dream. In class, we've studied historically racist policies that continue to impact African-American families today.
Specifically, we've taken a look at redlining maps of the greater Philadelphia area. Redlining was when bank lenders drew lines around neighborhoods that they considered to be risky, and racially divided communities that continue to be segregated today. We have thought about our own neighborhoods and discussed some ways that they are and are not diverse. We see the effects of redlining in our streets and in our schools, and it's up to all of us to truly carry out Dr. King's vision of integration.
Integration does not necessarily mean that America must be a melting pot. Through a reading of A Raisin in the Sun, we became familiar with the concept of assimilation, which is when the members of a group must give up their own unique characteristics in order to fit in with the dominant culture. Rather than integration through assimilation, we believe that America can resemble a salad bowl. In this model, we can live in harmony among one another without giving up unique aspects of our culture.
This is what we strive for at Chipley. In order to embrace a multicultural education, we should all honor and learn from one another's unique perspectives. This is why Black history is not something we should celebrate during the month of February alone. Black history is American history. So we can carry the lessons of Langston Hughes, Lorraine Hansberry, and countless others with us all year long.
Good morning. As we think about the theme, Courage for the Deed, we must remember the times where Courage for the Deed was critical to the growth of our nation. The third grade is currently studying a unit on civil rights. We have learned about many civil rights activists who were courageous in the fight for justice for all Americans. Today, we would like to present to you a scene from the play Speaking Out for Justice by Sheila Sweeney. We thank you for listening.
On August 28, 1963, more than 250,000 people marched in Washington, D.C. Rose, Jack, stay close. We have to stay close.
Equal rights! Equal rights! Equal rights!
You see that man up ahead? Pay attention to that man up ahead. He's going to make history for what he's doing. You should all remember his name.
The guy at the front?
That's Reverend Martin Luther King, Jr. He's been speaking out for equal rights for a long time.
He's the one who talked about how important it is for all of us to vote.
Yes, Rose, and he's traveled all the way over, all the way to India to find ways we can get our rights without using violence.
I heard that he even met with President Kennedy to ask him to support equal rights.
That's right, Jack. Now let's listen to what Reverend King has to say. At the Lincoln Memorial, the crowd stopped to listen to the words of Reverend King.
Look, it's Reverend King.
And all these people are listening to him.
I have a dream that my four children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day the state of Alabama will be transformed into a situation where little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls and walk together as sisters and brothers.
Your dad and I have that dream too.
When we let freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Dad, when I listen to Reverend King, I just know he's right, and I know things are gonna change.
I think you're right, Jack. You can all follow his example and hope for a better future for your kids.
Thank you, everyone. That was wonderful. I wonder if you could help me join me with a couple of thank yous, not just for our speakers just here, but for our jazz ensemble, for our crew, our singers this morning, and also for there's a group of students who are helping Mr. Plo do the live streaming and the audio and visual. Can you give everybody a hand and their teachers for helping? It is remarkable to me how events like this come together. A simple assembly. A lot of people have a lot to do, whether it's a march on Washington or just an all-school assembly. There's a lot of hands that go into pulling that off. And I'm eternally grateful for all those folks. And I just want to pause on that for a minute. It's little things that help us do that. The reason we come together for an all-school assembly, just like the reason we come together in class, is to learn. Right? Is to learn and to share and to do that together. And there's lots of little things we do. Right, like this little gesture, right, when we do this, right, that's a little gesture that one person can start that someone else can do. And then once you do that, that little hum that everybody's talking about, right, it reminds them that, oh, it's time to be quiet so that we can be together and honor and celebrate the folks who are going to speak or perform. Right, it's one little act that brings the collective together, and that bringing together of the individual and the collective is really what this assembly is all about. It's the courage to hold on to your own identity at the same time that you're part of something larger than yourself, right? And that's that balancing act, that tension between the melting pot and the salad bowl. And that brings me back to kind of where we started with this whole thing, which is this the idea of courage for the deed, the courage to do that, to be your own individual, to own your own identity, but to be part of something larger than yourself, to be part of a community. And that's effectively our question for today, right? And it's always good to start and to finish with, why am I learning this? Sometimes you ask this in class and your teachers might take a deep breath, right? But we're gonna finish where we started, which is, why do we learn about, why do we celebrate Black History Month? I'm going to take a page out. I mean, Declan said he's a white guy, but I am really a white guy. Right? This is my Ancestry.com DNA. Right? I mean, Declan, all due respect, like, the only way I could get whiter is if we put, like, Norway in there a little bit. So it does seem silly for me in my identity to stand up here and talk about why we study Black History Month. Well, here's my answer. I'm going to need some help with this one. I'm going to ask the lower schoolers to see if they can help me with this one. All right, see if you know, look at the screen, see if you know, and we don't have to raise our hands on this one. We can just call it out, okay? All right, see if you know who this is.
Jackie Robinson.
All right, piece of cake on that one, all right? Piece of cake, Jackie Robinson, first Major League Baseball player, first African-American Major League Baseball player. All right, I got another one for you. Are you ready? All right, another Barack Obama, first African-American president. Great job. All right, they're going to start getting harder now. You're going to get a little harder here. You have to think on this one. Very good, I heard it. The answer, in case you didn't hear it, Guy Buelford, he is the first African-American astronaut, grew up not far down the road here. He went to Overbrook High School. He's a Philly guy, all right? These are heroes we study and lots others. We have some of our own heroes. We have some of our own heroes here at Shipley, right, who forge similar paths, right? And like many things at Shipley, it often starts with three young women, right? Much like the Shipley sisters, in 1964, we had three courageous young women who were the first African-American students here at Shipley. Betty, June, and Beverly, one as a senior, one in ninth grade, one in eighth grade, were the first African-American students here at Shipley, right? And like the three heroes you just saw before, right, it took a lot of courage for them to do what they did. It also took courage for the people around them to support them. Right? And we often, when we tell these stories, we start with Jackie Robinson playing for the Dodgers, or Barack Obama's inauguration, or those three young women their first day here. But the story started much before that. Right? It started back when they were younger, when they were your age, right? Where their parents, their teachers, the people around them helped them develop the courage to do those really difficult things. And the reason we study this is to learn from that courage, to learn not just from the courage it took, but the long, difficult path it took to get there. And I will tell you again, as a white American, right, whose ancestors basically are from a certain set of Europe, this is not my history. I can't tell this history as my own. But it is absolutely 100% our history. And it's not just our history together, it's essentially our history. Because this story of what it took those three young women to come to Shipley, and those heroes and all the faces and stories that you see on the screen and all the ones that you will study this month in February, that is essentially our history, our Black history. And just like we need to carve out time to do important things, we need to carve out time to sleep, to eat, to study, right, to spend time together with loved ones, right, to celebrate, to mourn, and to grieve, we carve out this time in February for Black History Month to make sure that this important history, our important history, doesn't get pushed out of the way. Just so we make sure that sleep doesn't get pushed out of the way or time with family doesn't get pushed out of the way. We need to focus for a period of time on this, our Black history. And I encourage you to lean into that this year, to learn from those lessons, right? So own your own identity, but to share in our collective identity. Because by doing that, just like when we raise our hand and are both make an individual act but are part of something larger, we are stronger together as a community here at Shipley and as a country. So thank you for leaning into that this month. Thank you for all the individual and collective acts you'll take, and not just this month, but throughout the year, to help us be stronger in that way, to have courage for all those individual deeds. And with that, I ask you to stand and rise, and we'll celebrate that by singing our school song.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming together to honor and celebrate Black History Month and Courage for the Deed. Have a wonderful day. And as always, please help us by putting your chairs away. Have a great day.